escapes this week. So we've done messed up. Riley has gotten my back. I need to escape very quickly. So first thing we're going to do is address the hand that is most likely to be choking us, which is going to be a hand that is over your shoulder. That's the first thing we need to do is find that wrist. I always like to just kind of grab over his wrist, elbow down, and roll that wrist that little bit. Just gives a little bit of pressure to the wrist so that it makes it harder for him to start choking. Now, I'm also going to go to the opposite side of the hand that is over my shoulder. So if you fall to this side, you are on what's referred to as the pillow of death. Nothing good happens on this side of the body. So when I'm here, boom, I'm going to cup the wrist, roll down, keep my arms tight. I'm then going to fall to the opposite side. My goal is then to post my top leg on the mat and get my bottom leg over his ankle. Because he's going to be driving hooks, doing things, I want to get my leg over this ankle. Next step, I'm going to post, scoop my hips out, and start turning into him as much as I physically can, keeping this elbow in. That's another reason I like that. Grab the wrist and down, because it tucks this elbow in for me to help lock this leg. Now, once you get here, you're just going to keep turning in, scooting away, hopefully landing in some semblance of a half guard. Riley comes up here, you're going to land somewhere around here for cycle. The goal is get him off your back, then address getting to positive positions. So we're here, Riley grabs. Top hand. If you grab this bottom hand, you're like, oh, I'm doing great things.
Like being choked.
This is always the choking hand. So when I'm here, I'm grabbing that hand that's over my shoulder. I'm going to force myself this way and start rolling my shoulder blades to the mat and my hips. Getting this leg over. I will actually step on his feet if I have to. That's actually a great way to grab control. Because he'll be trying to dig these hooks and trying to hook stuff and do stuff. I will actually step on that hook. Get myself up there. Once I'm here, I come out. Reset to butterfly guard, neutral, scramble out and away. Just reset yourself from bad position. Realize, guys, that the back, in my opinion, is the more dominant in between back and mouth. I prefer to have your back. Because not only am I in complete control of you, I'm also behind you, which makes countering me a lot harder. So there's not a fun exit from here. You've got to move, and you got to do things quickly. Questions on this? Most of you guys were here Tuesday. Questions? Not that good, guys. Well, we should have some questions. So Riley goes to the other side. I'm here. Trapping here. And I'm going to still block with this hand. Tucking my chin. Start rolling my hips over. Stepping over that ankle there. Turn. Blocking the leg. Right. I'm up. Blocking that mount take. Blocking as much as I can. Getting back right.
I've had people where, like, as soon as I get
started
to
try to
go to the side,
I'm going to
reach through with the leg that they
hook triangle over and hook
the top of the other leg.
Make sure I'm hearing you right. So I'm here.
And they take that bottom leg and they reach through
over. Like,
into
a body lock or coming
no,
out just like?
Hook
up,
so, like,
hook
just like.
Like, trying to hook that knee?
Yeah.
And that's going to be some of that positional fighting that you're going to have to do. The biggest thing you're going to want to do here, guys, is not so much with your chest, but it's getting your hips over this knee. Because even if he's trying to reach through and grab with all his legs and hooking and doing all this fun stuff, if I can get my hips just over that knee a little bit, blocks about 90% of his motion and what he's able to do. That's the biggest thing, is hips over that knee. Once you've broken the backpack break, and you've got your hips over that knee, you're out, it's just not messing it up in between there and the exit. Does that make sense? If I hold it, his strong side, I'm going opposite chin to shoulder. So like if I happen to fall this way,
I'm tucking into my shoulder here and protecting my chin as much as I can. Because this side of my neck's gonna get choked regardless what happens. The goal is to protect this side of my neck.
Okay.
Now you obviously want to avoid this side. Now if you get over here and move it,
you know, you can still hit that escape. But ideal world, you go opposite of the arm that's over the top of your shoulder. Other questions, guys? One more time, just for fun of it. One more game speed. Riley's trying to choke me and do uncivilized things. I don't appreciate that. Fall to that side. First thing I'm doing, turning my hips, turning that shoulder. Walking here, trying to get those out of my way. Boom. Coming up, find me either to a top position, out to the screen. Questions, comments, concerns? Roller out. One, two. So now I'm here with Mr. Riley. And let's say for whatever reason, I'm not comfortable hip out escaping that way. Riley's got really good hips. He's going to take them out. Let's say I'm just not comfortable being in like a half guard position or like butterfly guard. I need to get to top position, or I need to just escape out. All right, so we're here. Still going to start the same way. I'm going to start by getting my hands on this lock. Now, my hand that is, he's underneath, I have to get this wrist on the outside of this elbow. So I'm going to break and try to start dragging that elbow in, because the goal is to hand fight your way to Home Alone defense. We've all seen Home Alone, right? Except for the 12-year-olds in the room, right? Ah! That's what we're trying to get to. So we're here, he's locked in. I'm going to start hand fighting, protecting my jaw. And the big thing is you want to elbow in and start hand fighting your way through. So it's a lot of down and elbows in. Kind of just swimming your way till you're in, both elbows in, he's not under your arms, so all you can do is really lock over the top of your arms to try to stop. Now, once we get here, I'm going to dig my heels into the mat just that little bit. I'm going to walk them forward. I'm going to pull my butt out just a little bit. Now, once I'm here, a couple things are going to happen. Riley's going to start to panic because he's losing all control. I'm going to scoot again, and one of my shoulders is going to pop out. Naturally, it'll be one or the other, just kind of a which leg has a better pull. Jim. The second this shoulder hits the mat and gets under his knee, I'm going to scoop, scoop, kick this knee over, this knee under. Wrestle up from that position at that point. Your goal is to get yourself scooted away without him having any. So we're here, he's got his grip, hand fighting, elbows in, chin down, hand fighting, and we got here, right? I've now defended myself. Now, do not leave your arms hanging as you go to scoop yourself out. You'll walk yourself straight into an arm lock. This is gonna feel unnatural at first. But when I'm here and I've got myself good and defended, Riley's gonna start trying to rip my face off, trying to choke. Boom. You literally just slide out at that point. The hardest part of this is getting to that Home Alone position. You have to, pushing those wrists down, elbow over. Pushing the other wrist down, elbow over. And it's not gonna be a clean, oh, I pushed both arms out once and now I get to slide out. He's gonna be here, I'm gonna get this hand out, and then as I'm going here, he's gonna be fighting there, boom. Now I can go. Once I'm here, slide again, one comes out. Questions on this, guys? Realize, escaping the back is the greatest example I can give you guys of simple but not easy. I hit this actually more in the gi than I do. Gi makes it a little tougher, but yeah. No gi has a faster pace. I think you guys all realized that Tuesday that we're here. No gi has a different pace. It's a lot faster. It's a lot more motion involved. There's not as much stalling. There's not as much grab or grip and cutting out. It's a lot of explode, stay. Explode, stay. That's what a lot of no-gi is. So in no-gi, people are ready for something like this. In the gi, it's actually a little less common. Questions on there?
So you get under his legs, are you circling into his legs?
Whatever shoulder comes out That's the leg that you're going into. So like if I get to here, this arm's out, right? I'm coming out and over the top of this leg. Couple reasons why. If I go this way, you're like trying to roll him. That's gonna be a lot harder to do for someone with a good base. Where if I'm here, I'm just trying to get onto the same leg. Now I'm here, now I can wrestle, I can break off. There's nothing that says I have to stay engaged right there. I can't run, but you can get back, reset, then re-engage. So I'm trying to go to that leg and get into that almost like single leg. Other questions? Generally not. This is going to be, unless the tournament gives reversal points, which is pretty uncommon, honestly. I've only seen a couple tournaments do it. This isn't going to score. But if I do this and then pass real quick, that can be two or three. You know, that can start to score at that point. But the goal is not be choked, not score points. If you've gotten your back taken, your first priority is not points at that stage of the game. You're probably down anyway, so we can just punt that part. We gotta escape, get ourselves back to a defensible position, then attack. Yeah, if I'm here and a guy's playing real wide meat and you'd end up both shoulders out, pick side, any side. There's not really a preference at that point, other than which direction you want. So for me, I will always move this way because that makes my right hand the heavy. But that's a preference, not a dominance thing. Other questions on that? Yeah, so the kind of the pacing of how this works. I'm here, right? Riley got a hold of me. We're here, we have to be not slow but deliberate. You know, we can't just recklessly try to break and do this because at any point your neck can get snapped. So we're being deliberate, kind of defending ourselves. Once we've made the tactical decision that we're going, it's going. There's not a... It's kind of a... Wait for the beat drop, right? Listen to rap music or whatever. Yeah, it's kind of slow, builds up. I have hand fighting. I have hand fought out, drop the beat, go. You know, that's when you have... At that point, it's go time. You can't hang out there at that point. Because the longer I hang out here, guys, this is why I tell you not to leave your arms hanging out. So let's say I beat this, but as I start to scoot, I do this. You're walking into an arm. Or a triangle, or a variety of other fuckery. It's just not great for anyone involved. That's why once you get to your hands inside here, you have to keep them inside and keep going. Questions on that? Fill her out. 1, 2, 3. Riley's got diabetes. Sounds like weakness to me. So I'm here, and bad things have happened to me at a very extreme level, because Colby now gets a body lock. Nothing great happens after a body lock. A lot of airway restrictions. If you do it first me, you're probably cracking ribs at that point when I get a hold of this. So this isn't a position we want to get into, right? Because nothing great happens. So a couple things we can do after this. If Colby's dumb enough to reach his ankle through and hook this for you, just very nicely, very politely drive your hips forward while driving your ankle back. You'll break his ankle, probably part of his neck. Because when you're here, you lock in, breaks that. Now, let's say that you're either in a competition that doesn't allow for foot locks, or he's not dumb and doesn't put his ankle behind your leg. First priority is still protecting yourself from the choke. Once we're here, I'm going to go onto the locking side, regardless what side that happens to be for the hands. Even if he's switched, he should be this way. But if he's opposite, does not matter. Still deal with the lock first. Once you're here, I'm going to post and come to this side. Next step, all I'm going to do, drive my knee flat and my other leg on top. I'm going to drive this knee out to break that lock. So he's here, he's body locking me up, dragging this knee straight to the mat. Dragging that up so that it breaks that lock here. Then guess what? Same escape from the first one. Attack the cheap ankle lock if available, especially if they're dumb, like Colby is most days. So I'm here, I'm defending myself, right? Always addressing the choke first. When they've taken your back, priority one, defend the choke. Because bad things start to happen when you don't do that. Once you get here, fall to this side. I always try to step over and hit that ankle lock real quick, just in case. But if that doesn't work, this leg goes flat, and I'm trying to drive that ankle and leg forward while driving my hips forward. Once I'm here, then I'm still defending the hand, turning out.
If you guys notice, he's having pressure on like my head where I'm sitting. When he comes to his back, he's trying to put pressure on my head. Because when he starts to push his foot out, if he doesn't, when he comes up here,
the other reason blocking is his hands is important. You want to stop this from driving just straight over and into Max. Because then you've traded one bad position for an almost equally as bad position. Now, as far as this foot lock goes, guys, you're going to try it very slowly with your friends, very quickly with your enemies. So here, I like Colby most days, so if I decide to step over on this, I'm going to very slowly step over here, hit it slow. Now, if I didn't like Colby, I'd go like this. So I'm here, fall onto this side, driving this leg flat, and I'm trying to drive this leg up to cause one of two things to happen. He's either going to try to switch sides on the body block if he's pretty squirrely, which then allows you to hit some blocking and, you know, you can get some things in the way. Or you can hit that same first escape, you just have to unlock the box first. Questions on that? Big guys, realize this will be less of an issue for you. If you're in the under 200 club, you're gonna run into some lanky people occasionally. What's up? Big one. So you gotta be able to break that body lock. Even if you're like, oh, there's no way they'll get a body lock on me. You get a body lock on a lot of people. Like, oh, that's okay. I enjoy it. So, all right, one, two.